The 15th annual Franklin Harvest Festival kicked off in a big way. With over 130 vendors, live music, face painting, and food, this year's event was a one for the books. The Harvest Festival is a time for vendors to display their goods and for people in the community to come out and get to know each other by shopping local. This year's festival once again successfully encouraged people to do just that. We spoke to people making a difference not only in our community, but also around the world, as well as volunteers and staff behind the coordination of the Harvest Festival. Here's a look at the big day. Tell us a little bit about what brings you to the Harvest Festival today.
Well, today we have a special emphasis on trying to help the folks that have been devastated by the flood that's been caused by hurricanes over and over in the South and in Puerto Rico, you know, all the places that are on the news. We have a church organization, UMCOR, United Methodist Committee on Relief, which distributes. There's no more administrative costs after we make this collection and give them the materials to distribute them to the places where they're needed. And Methodism in the United States is very broad spread, especially in the Bible Belt in the South. So there's going to be a lot of local churches that are going to be involved on site. But in addition to the materials that we will send and the things that are available in cash financial support, there's going to be relief teams that will go, and John's been on a lot of these volunteer and mission type teams. Volunteer and mission is local, and then there's been other major commitments to go to New York, to go to Katrina's devastation in the Orleans, Louisiana area, and to go wherever they're needed. The organization is a global organization, but we've been hit hard in the United States, and I think that everybody needs to pitch in to be able to do something about our fellow brothers and sisters that are in need everywhere.
Yeah, so the presence of the Harvest Festival is an opportunity for us, get the word out about what we're doing, and frankly, what we, that Franklin as a community is doing. And secondly, you know, so I had two of my neighbors see that we were doing this. They went and prepared their own flood buckets, came here and worked with our youth to actually pack them here a little while ago. And so hoping to understand and see the tangible aspects of real recovery is really important. And so the buckets are meant for essentially the work that needs to happen right after relief. So after a storm, there's an initial phase that we don't get involved in, because that's the public safety officials doing what we'll call the rescue activity. So it's once the ambulances are gone, the roads are cleared, then the volunteer organizations, and many of them are church-based, but there are others as well, can come in and start the work of both cleaning up and then going to actually restoration. These buckets really support the cleanup phase.